What could it be that would be causing the tree to not know that it is yet dead?
Well, you know, some of the real tells with trees are you'll have tip decline, or the tops of the trees will start to fade a bit, and you lose the leaves prematurely in that part of the tree, and you think, okay, when it's declining from the top, you've almost invariably have a root issue, which means the whole tree could come over. It may have a disease or some sort of decay column or a problem within the tree that's causing that decline. And invariably it's in the roots. And that's when you start taking information from the tree, asking it questions and listening to its answers in one way or another, and figuring out what is really going wrong with it. If in fact it is a tree that might become a hazard or a zombie.
Yes. So when you say a root issue, and so interesting to me that you can identify that from the top of a tree, the furthest part away from, is that that's where the new growth happens. Is that why?
Right, right. And it's from the root. So let me do this thing. Val Rao, this great instructor, told us before. Let me see here. Got your roots and your roots and your shoots. Your roots start declining, your shoots start declining, and they're supposed to be in balance. So these grow and these grow. So when you start losing it from the top down, probably in the ground where you should be looking.
Interesting. And is there a way that the homeowner can, I mean, besides looking at the tips or the crown of the tree, are there other things that homeowners can do to identify?
Another great tell, if it's not really going from the top down and one of those trees that doesn't know it's dead, it looks perfectly healthy, you might want to check the base of the tree, because that's where most of your other problems start showing up. And you'd have fungus on the base, shelf fungus coming out of the trunks, buttress flares that are just decayed and cavities and lots of insect activity, looking for borers and those sorts of things. There are just dozens of different things to look for, but specifically the tops and then the root crown of the tree. And that's the part where it swells and you get this root flare where the soil meets the trunk.